shadow. People, right now, it's like almost 3 a.m., okay? But I thought I looked cute today, so I was like, oh my god, let me film a video. And a video that I have been meaning to film, that is just getting worse and worse as time goes on, is my monthly favorites for the month of December. So people, first of all, let me just tell you, my makeup. So, if you can tell, like, my eyeshadow look is, like, super, like, my eye look is super, super, like, simple. But I've been really into this eye look. Not always do I wear false eyelashes, but today I did because I went to a party and I didn't really have time to do, like, you know, like big creative look. So I just did this look, and I've been doing this look a lot. So basically, it's just like a matte, like white color. Here, let me just show you. It's been one of my favorite things that for this month is the Naked 2 palette. Honestly, I rarely ever touch this palette except for this color right here, Foxy. And out of all three of my Naked palettes, Foxy is the only one I even hit pan on. I use this color mostly for an eyebrow, like under my eyebrow highlight, because I like a matte highlight underneath my brows most of the time. But I've been using it like on my lid, and yeah, so I think I need to buy the single version of it, just because like I am hitting pan. And then in my crease, I've been using this matte color called Tease. It's kind of like a purpley gray kind of color, a mauve or like taupe, I don't even know. And then I've also used this palette because I've been really into the 1970s, like the whole fashion, hair, makeup culture of the 1970s. So they used a lot of like silver and gray when they would like dress up for like, you know, disco looks. So for that, I've been using this color Pistol and this color Verve and also Suspect. So yeah, so I've been using this palette a lot this month. So yeah, this is my favorite. Like, also this makeup look. If you guys want, like, a tutorial, I can do that. But anyways, it's getting hot. I put this jacket on because I was cold in my room, and I'm getting hot. Okay. And then another Urban Decay product that I've really been liking is the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. And I got this, like, a few months ago, yeah. Or last month. November is when I got this. And at first I didn't really like it because I thought it was, like, super, like, wet. Like, the formula was really wet and, like, thick and, like, it, like, clumped my eyelashes. Slash, yeah, it just, I didn't really like it too much. But now that the formula has dried up, and also what I do when I put it on is I wipe the whole like wand on the edges here to get off like all the extra product. A tip that I learned from Wayne Goss, makeup artist, he's on YouTube. I can link his channel down below if you haven't checked him out yet. But honestly, I've learned more from him than I have learned from anyone. Maybe a tie with Candy Johnson, but yeah, he's amazing. But yeah, and this just like allows you to build more coats than if you just like use the wand straight out of the tube, you know? Because it doesn't deposit as much product. So yeah. And the reason why I like this is because it's like super, super black. So you can see my eyelashes are like so black. And yeah, I just like that, okay? makes your eyelashes, like, you know, stand out more. That's basically it. And then I have three Lime Crime products. So the first product is this eyeshadow helper. This is just the original eyeshadow helper. It's just in different packaging from like when I first bought it. But when I first bought it, I used it for my kit and I didn't really use it on myself because it was in my kit. So, anyways, I've had this for a while and I've only been like, because I've been running, like trying to finish up my primer potion from Urban Decay. So I haven't really been using this regularly, but now that my primer potion's out, I've been using this all the time and I love it, people. You don't even know. Like, it's a difference. Like, you can tell the difference in when I don't wear this compared to when I do wear this, because when I do wear this, the color is just so much more vivid and like more true to what it should be, and it just blends easier, it just lasts longer. People, I love this step. And my next Lime Crime purchase that I'm gonna make is going to include the eyeshadow brightener, which is like a white primer. Need. Anyways, I love this one. Like, I will never go back to another eyeshadow primer. This is the best. Another product that has been like everywhere on the internet, like Graveyard Girl has been wearing this a lot, and like I've just seen it everywhere on the internet, is the Lime Crime Velveteen in Cashmere. People, I've been wearing this a lot, and it's a grayish, but yeah, it looks different on everyone. So like the way it looks on me might not be the way it looks on you, but that's how I find a lot of the Velveteens are. Like, they look a certain way on one person, looks different on someone else. But what I can't say is that I love the way it looks on me. At first I was like, I don't know if I like this or not, but honestly, I just love it. It's like, I think because the gray in it, it doesn't make it too pale. It like, you know, makes it like darker. I don't know. I just love it. Okay. And it's a Velveteen, so whatever. Oh, and just so you guys know, I'm wearing the Velveteen Pansy on my lips right now. And everyone was saying how they were like concerned about if the purple is going to make your teeth look yellow. Does it make my teeth look yellow? No. So, love Pansy. And then the next Lime Crime product that I've been loving this month is the Carousel Gloss in Cherry on Top. Did I mention this in another favorites? I'm not sure. But I posted a picture of it because I couldn't decide if I wanted to wear this or this. And one of my friends was like, it looks like a red vine, which it kind of does. But I love this. I mean, it's as opaque as it is in this. When you put it on, it's like super opaque. Stays on long, and it even leaves a like pinky reddy stain. So I really, really like this product, and I want more colors. And also, people, it like, because glossy kind of finishes for lip products makes your lips look bigger. So, and whereas matte colors make your lips look more small. And so I always stayed away from glossy products, partly because they always came off so easily, and partly because I didn't really think that my lips needed to look any bigger, because to be honest, people, when I was growing up, I was always self-conscious about my lips because they're like so big, and people always commented on them, and people always thought like, oh my gosh, are you like part black? Like, seriously, people ask me that. no, I'm not. But I don't know, I just really like the way, I don't know, it just like accentuated something that I thought was not like a good thing, and it accentuated it to make it look like a good thing. So anyways, that's why I like it. Okay, anyways, and then I have this product from, I got it from Sprouts, my like health organic grocery store. It's from the brand Desert Essence, and I got this because you guys remember like a few months ago, I think it was last month or the month before, I had an issue with my hair in that I didn't use heat protectant and it just like shriveled up my hair and the ends were just awful, so I had to cut them. I got this because it's a coconut hair defrizzer and heat protectant. So it's basically like coconut water and a whole bunch of other stuff. Coconut oil, glycerin, aloe vera, soy protein, just a ton of stuff in here. But it's not tested on animals, so that's why I got it. And it actually works great as a detangler too. So when like my hair is like in between washes and I need to like brush it out, I just spritz this all over and I just like comb it through, like brush it through with my tangle teaser, and it helps so much. And actually like the way it smells, and I just really like this product, and I think it's like almost gone. So I definitely recommend this if you're looking for a good like heat protectant slash detangler slash defrizzer that's cruelty free. So yeah, and it wasn't that expensive at all. So definitely recommend this. And then for Lush products this month, I have my Snow Fairy Sparkle, which looks massacred in here. This one actually I had since last year. I actually got this free when I worked at Lush, when we had our little like Lush conference thing where we learned about the holiday products. This was a free product that I got then. I just never used it because it has like pearlescent glitter in the center, so you can see right there. And I just never thought like, when would it be appropriate for me to like sparkle? And so I busted this out when I did the Christmas parade for my hometown. And I like just put it like on my decolletage. And then I really liked the way it smelled. And then it left my skin super soft. So then I just started using it like for any day. So I use it like I would like a body lotion kind of. So I take it out and I like rub it mostly where I have stretch marks because the Mura Mura butter like deeply like penetrates your skin and like helps like moisturize and heal it and everything like that. So I use it like on my arms where I have stretch marks, my thighs and my butt and my boobies. So I really like this. And like, let me just tell you a difference between this one. This one smells like cotton candy, and then like the new Snow Fairy Sparkle, because I got a new one this year, it smells more like bubble gum. So I don't know if it's just because this one's older or, yeah, but they're supposed to have the same scent, but I don't know, I just really like it. Okay, I just really like it, okay? Just really like Snow Fairy Sparkle. And another massage bar that I got this, I think I got it whenever I did my giant Lush haul. But yeah, it's the Wiki Magic Muscles, and I love this stuff. People, if you work out a lot, if you're an athlete, this is great. You just like rub it all over your body, and when you're rubbing it, the like adzuki beans are like putting like pressure on your sore muscles, and then like the ingredients in here, the peppermint, the cinnamon, the clove, like have like a cooling and warming effect at the same time. So it like really helps you relax. And not only that, but like it is like oils in here, so like you're getting like moisturized too at the same time. So really, really love the Wiki Magic Muscles. The last Lush thing is the Roots hair treatment from Lush. I've talked about this before in other videos, but I have like a new appreciation for it this month because it actually helps like give your hair volume. And you know, with like, I've been so into like the 1970s hairstyles and everything 1970s, this really helps me achieve like voluminous hair. And I don't even have to like, I don't even have to blow dry my hair. I just let my hair air dry after, and my hair is like volume. So I really, really like this hair treatment. So I'll leave a link down below when I reviewed this along with all the other hair masks from Lush, so you can like get more information. But yeah, I just really discovered that it gives a lot of lift to your hair without even like trying to do anything to it. So I really like this one. And yeah, so that is everything that I like this month. Let me just give a shout out to There's a couple documentaries that I watched on Netflix this month. One of them was called 1964, and it's a documentary about all the important events of 1964. It goes over Lyndon B. Johnson becoming president. It goes over the Beatles coming to America. It goes over Betty Friedan's The Feminist Mystique. And just the whole progression of civil rights, going into like student activism, going into women's liberation, going into like all sorts of different movements. And I just love the 1960s. That is just, but anyways, and another documentary that's kind of in the same time period, like late 60s, early 70s, is called Candy Darling, or no, it's called Beautiful Darling. I think that's what it's called. But it's about Candy Darling, the like drag queen, I guess, that was really glamorized in Andy Warhol's films and everything like that. And it just like was really touching and I don't know, I just really like that documentary, and I love everything about Andy Warhol and all that stuff. So that's just a couple things that I've been obsessed with on Netflix. Anyways, people, that is everything. That was my favorite this month, and thanks for watching, people, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!